Hi! In this video, we'll take a look at where you can find Yoast SEO in your WordPress backend. Let's dive right in. The first location we're going to take a look at is the WordPress dashboard. When you scroll down on your dashboard, you'll find the Yoast SEO Post Overview meta box. This meta box contains two elements. First, there's an overview of the SEO scores of the posts you've published on your site, so you can see at a glance which of your posts could use some improvement. In this overview, your posts are divided into four categories: needs improvement, OK, good, and posts without a focus key phrase. And when you click on the category needs improvement, for example, it will take you to an overview of all of your posts that have bad SEO scores, so you can start optimizing them right away. And then there's the second element, an overview of the latest blog posts on Yoast.com, so you can easily keep an eye on the latest SEO news. You can also find the Yoast SEO plugin in the overview of both your posts and pages. Let's take a look at the posts overview. If you click Posts in the menu on the left-hand side, you can see all the posts you have on your site. On the right, there are four columns that are part of Yoast SEO. The first of these columns shows the SEO score of your posts, the second, the readability score. These colored bullets give you an easy overview of the scores for all your posts. Red means your SEO needs improvement, orange stands for OK, and green bullets indicate your SEO is good. The third column allows you to see at a glance how many outgoing internal links are in your post. And this is really convenient because a solid internal linking structure is crucial for your SEO. The final column shows you the number of internal links linking to this post. So it shows how many other posts on your site link to this post. See how convenient it is to have all of this information in your post overview? Oh, and keep in mind that to get the internal linking insights, you first need to go to SEO in the menu on the left-hand side, then click on Tools, and then hit the Start SEO Data Optimization button. This will allow Yoast SEO to analyze your internal linking structure, and you only have to do this once. And there's more. Yoast SEO also adds three filters to your overview: orphan content, stale cornerstone content, and cornerstone content. The orphan content and stale cornerstone content filters are only available in Yoast SEO Premium, so you won't see them if you're using the free plugin. But what do these filters do? Let's go through them quickly. The orphan content filter shows you all the posts on your site that you haven't linked to. As you may know, both search engines and visitors will have a hard time finding a post that doesn't have a link pointing to it. Therefore, it's really important to regularly check if posts show up here, and if they do, to start linking to them. Okay, next filter, the cornerstone content filter. What's that? Well, cornerstone content consists of the best, most important articles on your site. When writing a post, Yoast SEO allows you to indicate whether or not an article is cornerstone content. We'll get to that later in this video. With this filter, you can quickly see an overview of all the cornerstone articles on your site to make sure you're doing well on the most important parts of your site. The stale cornerstone content filter monitors the posts you've marked as cornerstone content and warns you if you haven't updated them for 6 months. Keeping your most important articles fresh is essential for SEO, and that's why we remind you to do so. There is one more thing we can do here. We can click on Screen Options, which will allow you to select the SEO title, meta description, and the key phrase. So if you apply this, you'll see that the SEO title, meta description, and the focus key phrase are added to this overview. Now let's take a quick look at the pages overview. Here you can see that all of the columns and filters we've discussed before are also available for your pages. When you're editing a page or post, Yoast SEO is also there to help you. You can find the Yoast SEO features in the sidebar and in the Yoast SEO meta box below your post. You can find all the features of the Yoast SEO meta box in the sidebar as well, so you don't have to scroll all the way down when working on your post. If you click on the Yoast logo in the upper right corner of the screen, the Yoast SEO sidebar will open. In this sidebar, you can enter your focus key phrase, view the results of the readability analysis, as well as the SEO analysis, and add related key phrases. Moreover, you can see the internal linking suggestions that Yoast SEO provides you with, if you're using the premium version of the plugin. With the next tabs, you can preview what your post will look like in Google search results and on Facebook and Twitter. Clicking these previews will open a pop-up modal where you can view and edit your search results and social shares. Next, you can change the schema settings for your post or page in this tab here, and you can set some advanced settings in, you guessed it, the Advanced tab. In the Cornerstone Content tab, you can mark your content as Cornerstone Content, the most important articles on your site. Finally, there's the Insights tab. Here you can see which words occur the most in your content, which indicates what your content focuses on. Are those words really different from your topic? Then it's probably good to rewrite your content a bit. As we've already mentioned, you can find the same settings when you scroll down to the Yoast SEO meta box, right here. The only difference is that the settings are divided into horizontal tabs: SEO, readability, schema, and social. Phew, this is a lot to take in, right? Just a couple more locations to go. Let's go back to the post overview and then head to the admin bar at the top. Hey, is that the Yoast logo? That's right. And when you click on it, you'll find shortcuts to the configuration wizard, some useful keyword research links, and the SEO settings. You can also find these SEO settings in the sidebar on the left. Here you see a menu item called SEO. Click on it and you'll be taken to the Yoast SEO settings. These settings are divided into a few categories: general, search appearance, social, tools, premium, and redirects. Don't worry, we're not going to go through all of them in this video. For now, it's most important that you know you can find them here. In the tools settings, you can find some Yoast elements as well. In the site health overview, you can find the results of the free indexability check that Write offers for Yoast SEO users. If your site can't be found by search engines, you'll see a warning here. If there are any other general SEO issues that require your attention, Yoast SEO will also notify you here with an issue that has the SEO label. By the way, if you are using WordPress 5.4 or later, you will find a widget called Site Health Status on your dashboard. If you click the link, you are taken directly to the screen we've just discussed. The last location where you can find Yoast SEO is the User Settings. Here you can change the role of people on your site. Yoast SEO gives you two new user roles, SEO Editor and SEO Manager, and you can manage what SEO things they can do. For example, you might not want everyone on your site to be able to do redirects, so you can determine who can set them and who can't. And with that, we've come to the end of this video. Now you know where to find all the elements of Yoast SEO in your WordPress backend.